Hello everyone, my name is Claire Liefrings. I'm FNRS postdoctoral fellow and member of the board, the Belgian Inflammatory Bowel Disease Research and Development Group. My colleague for this video is Jean-François Toubeau, also an FNRS postdoctoral fellow and member of the PSMR, the Power Systems and Markets Research Group, who are specialists in machine learning. We are presenting you a small video for explaining the key messages of our paper entitled Collecting New Peak and Intermediate Infliximab Level to Predict Remission in Inflammatory Bowel Disease. This study has been developed by the board in collaboration with 9 Belgian hospitals, which all contributed to enroll IBD patients. The analysis performed for this study have been implemented in collaboration with the PSMR group. The resulting paper has been recently published in IBD journal. You can find all information needed on this slide. Some words regarding the background of our study. In clinical practice, we know that the loss of response to infliximab over time remains a challenge in the management of IBD patients. In a previous study published in 2017, we suggest that the therapeutic drug monitoring at induction could help to predict remission later on during maintenance. Based on that knowledge, the aim of this prospective multicentric study is to improve predictive models of remission by exploiting new peak and intermediate infliximab measurement during the induction.
The problem of predicting remission in IBD patients is formulated as a binary classification problem. To that end, we defined two possible outcomes, remission and non-remission, and those two outcomes are defined based on clinical and biological parameters. To predict this remission in IBD patients, we have access to different types of data. First, we have pharmacokinetics data, which simply describe the evolution of the drug concentration in the blood. As a reminder, the goal of this study is really to capture those dynamics and to map them to the probability of remission of the patient. In complement, we have also access to phenotypic data, which are the general characteristics of the patient and of the disease at the baseline. Finally, we have also inflammatory biomarkers, such as leukocytes and CRP, which are typically measured with blood samples. This multicentric study has gathered information from 63 patients. However, from a modeling perspective, this number of data is relatively small, and dedicated models and methodologies need to be considered. First, logistic regression is used as a benchmark, which is widely used in medicine. However, logistic regression relies on strong assumption. Indeed, the analytical form of the model needs to be defined beforehand, and this may clearly prevent the model to capture all important dependencies within the data. This technique is thus complemented with two tree-based models, random forest and a gradient boosting classification tree. These models have been selected due to their ability to represent non-linear interaction among variables, but also for their flexibility and robustness with small datasets. One of the main contributions of the work is really to quantify the evolution of the prediction performance over time. For instance, it should be noted that more inputs are available at week 6 than at baseline. This new information mainly consists of additional measurements from blood samples that have been gathered during the induction period. To account for this increasing amount of information, different models are developed for the different time points of interest. Now, regarding the selection of relevant inputs for the models, we have looked at a trade-off between the size of the input space and the resulting quality of the model. For instance, a model with 50 inputs is too complex in the daily clinical practice. In this work, a maximum of 12 inputs were allowed in the developed models. And in practice, the importance of each individual variable has been estimated using a traditional classification tree, and then a random search has been carried out to identify the optimal combination of these input variables. When the most relevant set of inputs is selected, the objective is to calibrate the models and to evaluate their performance. To mitigate the low number of available data, a nested cross-validation framework is implemented. In this framework, all available information is fully exploited and we guarantee the robustness and significance of the prediction performance.
Now, let's move on to some key results. First, we observe that the new infliximab measurement, such as peak level at week 2 and intermediate level at week 3, were correlated with remission status at week 30. Also, we confirm that trough level at week 6 constitute an important time point for predicting remission as published in our previous paper. Regarding predictive model, we clearly observed an improvement of the area under the curve across the different induction time points. It should be noted that only random forest models are here presented. Focusing on one predictive model at week 6, we are seeing here that the area under the curve obtained by random forest achieve 0.9. For obtaining this accuracy, only three input features were selected by the model: lymphocyte count at baseline, neutrophil count at week 1, and infliximab trough level at week 6. Overall, our results highlight the importance to combine pharmacokinetic data with both clinical and biological data.
Now, let's conclude this presentation with the important take-home messages. Our study showed the clinical relevance of measuring new infliximab levels to predict the remission in IBD patients. Our findings lay the foundation for a personalized medicine in which biotherapies could be monitored at an early stage. This has a strong potential to improve the patient's clinical management in the future. Finally, our study demonstrated the interest for implementing new machine learning techniques to leverage the clinical and medical data and to improve the subsequent predictive models. We really hope that this small video has awakened your curiosity regarding the interest of combining machine learning and infliximab pharmacokinetics in the follow-up of IBD patients. Don't hesitate to check up the full paper using the links presented on the bottom of the slide. Thank you very much for your attention.